I am the godfather of B97FM. And I have to ask you for a favor that you cannot refuse. Listen to B97FM. Thank you. Well, welcome to the show. Today we're going to listen to a Paul McCartney concert. And after that, we're going to listen to some Beatles love songs. So I hope you enjoy it. I know I will.
This very big curtain around us. We were absolutely sure that we were stuck behind the curtain forever.
In Moscow, the Soviet Union celebrates.
Indeed, the Soviet government hasn't realized in the beginning how dangerous the Beatles were.
Something was happening that they wanted to control, and they didn't know how to do it. First cops, then KGB started to take notice and say, oh, something we don't like is happening, so we better do something about it.
I have heard of anyone who would be put in jail for listening to the Beatles records. But there's been a lot of other things in which the life of a young man could be seriously spoiled.
In the words of Russia's President Vladimir Putin, back then, McCartney's music was seen as alien propaganda.
East meets West today when the pop star Paul McCartney takes part in a revolutionary radio broadcast. The former Beatle will be taking telephone calls live from the Soviet Union.
Paul McCartney,
I don't know if music and politics have got much in common.
I think it is, in fact, one of the untold stories of the collapse of the Soviet regime. And Paul McCartney and the Beatles were at the forefront of that.
The Beatles was a phenomenon, and it was a phenomenon of freedom.
We're coming with Paul McCartney, has confirmed all ready for us. We are ready to rock Russia.
It was a historic moment for Paul.
A remarkable appearance tonight by one of the most famous rock stars in the world.
Tens of thousands of Russians cheering on former Beatle Paul McCartney.
40 years after conquering America.
So long in coming. Mostly USSR.
And thousands were there to greet him.
I listened to the Beatles at BBC Radio, the super group.
God bless you. We love you.
Сделай момент перестройки.
Oh, yeah.
The idea was being actually banned and being a bad influence on the youth, we knew to be untrue.
That, of course, was very widely spread unofficially in the Soviet Union. The authorities didn't prevent young people from hearing the music, but it was never officially sponsored or liked even by the authorities. But that was a long time ago.
They began in a very promising way for the Soviet Union. In the early 60s, we've had Yuri Gagarin, the first man in space. We've had the funky guy, Mr. Nikita Khrushchev, who promised to bury capitalism. So, generally speaking, communism looked and sounded really cool in the beginning of the 60s. The Russian people and the Russian youth in particular, they felt quite enthusiastic about what was going on in their country. Then by the mid-60s, things started to turn a little bit worse. The dissident movement had started, Soviet Union invaded Czechoslovakia, the Prague Spring was over. Instead of funny Mr. Khrushchev, we've got a very boring Mr. Brezhnev and his entourage. We all had to decide whether to stay loyal or to look elsewhere. Only some years later, they have suddenly became aware of the fact that the Beatles have started a whole huge movement in the Soviet Union, a movement which involved not thousands or even hundreds of thousands, which involved millions of young people who became, as communist publicists have said, inner immigrants. They still lived in the Soviet Union with their body, but mentally and spiritually they were somewhere else.
Marxism, Leninism, the very foundation for the Soviet system, said that the economic structure, the basis of a society, affected what he called the superstructure, which is everything, religion, music, the way people think. And there was something called a dialectical relationship, which meant the way people thought affected the way the economy functioned, and the way the economy functioned affected the way people thought. And therefore, you needed censorship to control the system. What you really had the Beatles doing was they were affecting the superstructure of the society, and it literally brought about that change, which was the collapse of the communist-style economy and the entire system. So in a sense, Paul McCartney and the Beatles acted out exactly what Lenin feared would happen. That scenario ultimately played out 70 years later. So in the end, Lenin was right.
Stay with us for more Paul McCartney in Red Square.
Paul McCartney in Red Square. Brought to you in part by Honey Nut Cheerios and by Acura.
Hi. I lowered my cholesterol.
That is nice.
I lowered my cholesterol.
In case you haven't already heard the news, Honey Nut Cheerios can help lower your cholesterol as part of a heart-healthy diet and with its sweet honey taste. That ought to make you really happy.
My cholesterol's down. Excuse me.
Honey Nut Cheerios. Be happy. Be healthy.
Behind them is a snippy maitre d' and a wilted Caesar. In front of them is a family drama playing itself out. But right now, life is perfect. Thanks to a full moon, a powerful engine, and the Autobahn-tested suspension of the Acura RL.
Hey, my customers are on the way. Where's the key? Hello?